Howdy folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Secret of the Silver Blades. Today we're probably going to have a slightly short episode. Alright, I figure these are all just teleporter squares. Yeah. Probably a slightly short episode. We're just going to be clearing out the Black Circle headquarters here. There's not a lot left. I just want to map it and see if there are any further goodies hidden. Oh, monsters attack. It's like legit just a pair of, like, what are these, hippogriffs? No, get fucking manual targeting, Jesus. Yes, just hippogriffs. Alright. Not worth blowing spell slots on, wow. I forget that, like, now that Brunhilde has that belt of giant strength, she's just going to be hitting, like, an absolute truck. 42 experience points. Good one. So I assume this takes us out. Yes, ruins of old verdigris. It's interesting that there's multiple entrances to this place. I wonder if you could stumble in on that side entrance and basically, like, skip this entire dungeon. What do we have here? Griffins? Yeah, actual griffins this time. Alright, we'll wait. Oh, they're waiting too? Oh no, here they come. I was gonna say, if they're just gonna hang back there, I'm going to fireball them. Yeah, I will absolutely saturate these things with fiery death. I have disintegrate. Let's try disintegrate. No, and of course it failed, because why would it succeed? See, this is the thing that sucks about the save or die spells, is that when they don't succeed, you get nothing. Except disappointment. I'm not gonna be able to hit all of these. I will, however, be able to hit all of these. Ooh, good fireball. Of course it didn't kill all of them, because why would it? 21 damage. Holy shit. Yes, that's right. Bring your pretty face to Brunhilde. I was gonna make a bring your pretty face to my axe joke, but she's not using an axe. Alright. That wasn't too bad. No treasure. So it seems like the random black circle encounters are now just replaced with here's some critter beasts. Yeah, like, just here's monsters. Random ogres and stuff. I think that's kind of cool, honestly. Like, it gives some continuity, right? Because, like, alright, I guess we chase the black circle out of here. But, I mean, like, monsters and stuff are always going to be looking for the opportunity to find a new place to lair. So, of course, like, the black circle's gone, but new critter beasts have moved in. Like, that's something that I always really liked in, like Westmarch's D&D games, is that, like, you're always supposed to assume that, like, even if the PCs have cleared, like, even if a party clears something, like, you know, critters are always gonna, like, there's always gonna be the vacuum, right? And if there's a vacuum, something has to fill it. So other critters are gonna just kind of move in. Kind of cool. I dig it. I like the continuity. It makes the world feel alive. Not that I'd be complaining if there just weren't any monsters here, because these are just fucking filler encounters, but still, like, it could be worse. Be a good place for a lightning bolt, I'm just saying. Fireball works good too, though. Another good one! Devon's starting to do some damage with these fireballs. 44 is a very good roll. I think he's like, what, 10th level? 10th level mage? Maybe? Flees in panic. And you ain't going nowhere. Alright. And this music, it always reminds me, this is Dungeon Master 2, but it reminds me of, Ravenloft Stone Prophet, and every time I hear it, I'm like, I need to get those soundtracks put together. And it just, I've talked about it before, that, like, I say I'm going to do it, and then as soon as I'm done recording, I immediately switch into, oh no, I've got to get editing and stuff done. So, like, I'll say I'm going to do something and it takes 4 years to happen because I've just, like, I have a process and I just immediately move on to, like, the next thing. That should be okay for Brunhilde and Goldleaf. Oh, I didn't hit that one on the right? Really? Disappointment. Things are surrendering. Man! I miss morale rolls in newer editions of D&D. Like, I don't know. It was something that, like, back in the day always made sense, and it complicated things, right? Because, like, let's see, what are we on? I think we're on I. It's easy if you've killed everything, right? You've got a bunch of corpses and you just search through them for loot and stuff, but what do you do if you've got surrenders? Because then, like, that's something you have to worry about. The commander of the guards is speaking apparently into thin air. You hear, they seem to have penetrated our area with ease. I think they're here. I'll take care of it now. He shouts and troops burst into the room. Okay, so apparently not all of these dudes are dead. And it looks like a bunch of veterans, a lord. Are those mages in the background? Yes. Fireball? Okay. No. Kill them both. Kill them both. Oh, of course one of them fucking made it save. That's right, throw your darts, you son of a bitch. Let's see. Maybe an ice storm. I don't think that. Because I think an ice storm, it's like a 5x5 area in total. So two squares in either direction, so that should hit all of them except for that trooper on the right. Seriously? 11 damage? Oh my god, you guys. You're killing me! I mean, he's probably just gonna, like, nail himself with, like, a globe of invulnerability. Or a lightning bolt, you know. I'm mad at Devon for that, because that damage roll was fucking trash on that ice storm. He didn't even do average damage, bro. Like, come on. Never equip your longsword. Fix that. Can't use the wand. I mean, I could, but I'm not going to. Now you get to sit there and guard like a fucking dumbass because you elected to just be a dum-dum. Alright, tank those guys AC a little bit. Let's D-door. Like up here. Now you can flank with Chunk. I don't know if this is necessarily worth more spells. We have so many scrolls here. Let's do a Cone of Cold. Cast Cone of Cold. It's like here. That spell's AoE is so fucking weird! Like, sometimes it does what I want it to, and other times it's just like, no. I'm just not going to. Because I hate you. I just don't know. It was recommended that I basically use it kind of like lightning bolt, and I'm like, yeah, at this point, yeah. Alright, Feeble Mind, that could be situationally really useful. Shield, just drop that. I'm never going to use that. Dimension Door, Minor Globe of Invulnerability, again useful. Ooh, delayed blast fireball, we're saving you for a good day. Here, lightning bolt. Alright. Lightning bolts are good. I could bounce it up against these guys, but I fully expect it's gonna come back and hit swell, but I don't care. Good lightning bolt. Oh, and it didn't! Esports! I totally knew that it wasn't gonna hit swell. Ha ha! Alright. 6,800 XP, not bad. We will take your jewelry, we will take your gems, and your gear is probably just like your standard. Yeah, it's just gonna be your standard bullshit. I will take the bracers. And that's a random javelin and a potion. Sling and banded mail. Alright, I'm gonna take those. I'm gonna take anything that looks weird. Non-standard. That's probably like random gen loot or something. On a desk, you find a report written to the commander and a map to the Well of Knowledge. You take the report and you record it as journal entry 16. You take the map and record it as journal entry 45. Alright, so I want to look at this map. So the map is basically from the east entrance of this, how to get back to the Well of Knowledge. Okay, that's nothing too important. And then entry 16, Black Circle Commander's Paper. We are prepared. The inner sanctum is well concealed, surrounded by a hatchling pool. We hope that the old red dragon will not miss the hatchlings. They provide an excellent defense. Soon, we must find a way to age them to a more useful size. Use the map to plan an attack on Well. We expect regular progress reports. If you fail, we will act on a suggestion made by a junior member. He believes that the dragon may be amenable to a human sacrifice. The clerk from Flan has become expendable and will be the first victim. One way or another, the dragon and its Banite allies will fall. The Well must be ours. Alright, you also find a large key. A portal stands at the other end of the room. Oh, really? I'm not going to enter this one. I'm going to save first. Because I don't know if this is going to take me back to the center? Or what? Oh, no! Alright. So... Black Circle HQ. So there was... like, a pre-boss battle. Quicker exit, I suppose. Interesting. Monsters attack! Yeah, okay. I love Fireball. It's just so good. I mean, like, just look at it. It's so good. I just can't even. Never enough Fireball. Holy shit. Is that like his third kill? Third kill with darts? I'm just gonna keep ending my turn until this thing, I was gonna say, gets down here. Accidentally quick combated Chunk, but I suppose that's not a bad thing necessarily. This is the armory! Black Circle Guards attack. Okay, well, we have more. Bunch of mages. Let's go ahead and use the Wand of Lightning on this group. Let's see. So we can nail this dude. These are warlocks. They're lower level, which actually leads me to believe that they're probably more likely to nail us with lightning bolts. But I don't think I'd be able to hit... this might get two of them. Yeah. I would say two's as many as I'm going to be able to get with a lightning bolt. Hold the line, Goldleaf. Rove, it would be wonderful if you could act, bro. Okay, so we have Fireball. What else do we have? Magic Missiles, Ice Storm. Yes. There's an Ice Storm right here. I think we'll hit all of them. It might also catch Gold Leaf, but frankly, I don't care. Oh, good Ice Storm. That was a good Ice Storm. See, like, that's the thing is, like... with Wands of Ice Storm, I would rather have Wands of Ice Storm and, like, the ability to buy them. Like, if I have that, I will never cast the spell, because there's no point, because the spell doesn't scale. So, like, as a wand, Ice Storm is, like, a good wand spell. Again, something that you don't get in, like, 3rd edition D&D, because stuff scales so fucking hard off of, like, caster level, generally speaking, or, you know, save DCs and stuff. So, like, you would never use a Wand of Ice Storm in, like, 3rd edition D&D. It's just, it's a terrible item to use. Because, I mean, first of all, Ice Storm's just bad in like, 3rd edition D&D. But secondarily, like, everything would make their saves. Ow. Okay. Man. I'm gonna actually move Devon here and have him delay. Have Rove come over here. And what do we have on here? Hold monsters and knock. Just use the... what's this one got on it? Stone to Flesh. Lightning Bolt. I like Lightning Bolt. eat 5d6 worth of electrocution damage. Goldleaf, you're doing admirably. Reinforcements have arrived. Devon is looking busy. While Brunhilde kills everything. Let's see, can I come here kill this guy? Ah, I was hoping he'd kill him. Because then I would have moved around as it is. I don't want to try moving Brunhilde through the fart cloud. Alright. What do we got? They said this was an armory, so I expect... Huh, I was gonna say I expect weird stuff. I'm gonna take that dart. Oh my god. Where is it? Take the dart. I'll take the dagger and the quarterstaff and the banded mail. And then bracers. Oh wow, were those... those other mages must have been like so low ranking they didn't even give them bracers of protection. That's fucking funny. Alright. I'm gonna encamp. We're gonna save. I was say, like, I was thinking initially that this would be a short... Guards burst through the door. I was gonna say this is gonna be a short episode, but based on all these trash fights, not looking like so much of that. Sounds 15-foot radius. We'll try. I tried. Well... Oh, so does that mean that these guys are silenced too? I don't know, let me check. No. Okay, so just that guy is silenced. Dang it, I was hoping that it would affect the other ones. Still, that's one less mage we have to worry about. Oh no, it does say that they're silenced. Maybe it does get all of them. That would be fucking wonderful. Yeah, they're silenced. Oh, get fucked, guys. Oh, and now... Now... Burn. One of them is gonna be immune to it. That's okay. And... Move here. Cone of Cold. This is gonna hit Brunhilde, I think. But I think maybe we'll also hit all of them? All of the mages? How does that work? Like, it's a cone, right? So it's like, okay, here. And then you'd think it would hit these. And then go out like this. But it's like, here. And then like this. And then this guy. Like, what the f- Oh my god. Cone of Cold. Like, people have explained, like, what the AoEs are for Cone of Cold and stuff, and, like, I get it, but this game just doesn't. The game just does not do Cone of Cold, how Cone of Cold should be, like... Like... It's incredibly obnoxious. It's like, oh my good god. Good hold person spell, though. That's pleasing. I can try feeble-minding that mage. I don't necessarily think it's worth it. Here, come here. So I want to see, if I have Rove, if I have him Cone of Cold this dude... How the fuck does that AoE work? It makes no sense. Also, that Cone of Cold did a shitload of damage. Here, Brunhilde, have a heal spell. Oh. Heal's good. Heal is so good. Okay. Take bracers out now. Brunhilde, take bracers. And that looks like just usual stuff. The banded mail might be gear on, like, just lower level warriors, now that I think about it. Okay, so my hope is that these rooms are just, like, empty barrackses. You have encountered a barracks area at the guard's charge. I was too hopeful. I'm thinking after this fight we might go back to town, because, like, these are slowly wearing us down and we're running out of spells. Let's see what you have. You have a one of lightning, which I see we can use here for some, chicanery. Ah, you love to see it. Cone of Cold is just gonna end in sadness, so how about... I know you've got a Wand of Ice Storm. There. Another 20. And then from here, I suppose melees can just kind of whittle things down. Although... Man, Devon, why you only gotta have 13 hit points? I'd have him step to the south and lightning bolt those four dudes on the bottom, but I think it would kill him. So instead I'm gonna have him lightning bolt these guys again and just clear this chunk of the board, maybe. Lightning bolt from that wand. Ah, disappointing, old person. Again, like, Cone of Cold, it's pretty good. Why don't you delay? Why is Chunk not getting backstabs anymore? This is incredibly irksome. I need to see my little man doing big damage, and I'm not. It's very upsetting. Alright. Man, this Wand of Lightning Bolt is getting some use. Good damage on it, too. 27, that's like almost max damage. Assuming it's casting at 5th level. Like, that's gonna cap at 30. They might just use, like, your actual class level. It wouldn't surprise me. It's just kind of a way to simplify things, but at the same time... I'm gonna just assume that they don't. Alright. These guys have money, I'll take it, but otherwise I'm not too interested. Take that. Take that. You don't care. Alright, we're getting back to town. And there's two more rooms. Yep. Okay. Come in here. Encamp fix. Encamp. All of the memorization. Silence spell actually made itself quite useful. Heal? No. Didn't mean to memorize harm. Can I, like... No. She would just let me, like, unmemorize. That would be convenient. But sadly, memorization only works one way. Stinking Cloud. Fireballs. Dimension Door. I'm actually okay with him having two Dimension Door spells, honestly. I think on Devon, Dimension Door is more utility than a lot of other things. Stinking Cloud. Fireballs. Did I use any of his lightning bolts? I think I cast one. Rove. Ice Storms. And Cone of Cold. And Disintegrate. Seriously? Oh my god, I am getting so fucking tired of these filler fights. So fucking tired of them. Because, like, now I have to go and memorize all of my spells again. It's like, the game is just, like, outwardly wasting my time, and I am just so done with it. these fucking fire knives with their bullshit poison. Like, ugh. Think these dudes drop anything worth anything, do they? Like, it's like plus one leather armor with insta-give poison on their knives. Why can't I take their knives? I would be raging so hard if I couldn't just encamp fix after these fights. Like, I'm annoyed enough at having to, like, rememorize all of our fucking spells. I mean, like, I know that the actual chance of, like, getting ambushed, it seems pretty small, and it's been small in all of the games, but it's, like, one of those things where it's just, like, I just want to be able to play the game, and, like, you are literally doing nothing except wasting my time with these fights. I am in no danger. Even if I weren't using Encamp Fix, I would be in no danger of a handful of fire knives. Okay, pool our money. Got a bunch of platinum, so we should be able to... most of this shit without too much issue. Potion of healing, nice. Plus one javelin, plus two sling. Ah, dart of the hornet's nest. Alright, this stuff is just all getting sold. Why is one dart worth so much money compared to just all of this other stuff? Like, why are bracers worth so much money? So weird, like, what's valuable and what's not. Because, like, I would think that, like, a plus two sword or something would be worth more than these bracers, but apparently not. Alright, so we've got 4,000 platinum. Let's share it all out. Okay. Like, that's 4,000. Oh my god, we have so much money. Alright. So let's see. Yes. Pool our money. 10,000 platinum, that's more like it. Okay. I want wands of magic missile. A lot of wands of magic missile. We don't have to buy two. Holy shit. Okay, so those things actually cost more platinum than I thought they did. Bear. Share out all that. View inventory. So you have two wands of magic missile. Rove, I think you've got at least one. Rove has two wands of magic missile. Wonderful. Absolutely, absolutely wonderful. I am super pleased with that. Actually, what's in this south room? Some assassins are here sharpening their weapons and perusing a map of the mayor's house. They leap to attack. They're running a shop out of this building and you guys didn't think to check for murderers. This fucking game. Like, I get it. They were probably expecting that the players would just come in here and clear, like, the entire building. But we came in here and I had to wuss out because we had the shit kicked out of us. Oh my lord. Oh, really? You guys are... I could do this. Let's see. Yeah, we'll fireball the front row. They can take it. Of course, the fire knives are all gonna make their saves in my front row. No one is going to make their saves. Ah, Brunhilde, Goldleaf. Alright, most of the front row made their saves. Less salty. We'll just actually go ahead and use this Wand of Lightning. Telling ya, this Wand of Lightning Bolts, it's giving a workout, and he's taking it twice. Nice. Okay. I'm not going to waste another lightning bolt on fire knives. I will waste the magic missile, though. Flees in a panic! Yeah, no. I'm not continue the battle. Is there anything fun in here? No, just leather armor. So I wonder if now that we've cleared this out... I'm not flip on search. I wonder if now that we've cleared this out, if attacks from fire knives will stop. It would be nice. Okay, so we will encamp fix one final time, and I think I'm gonna go ahead and call it here. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. Hope you had a good time, and I will see you next time. We're actually probably gonna go back to the mines now that I think about it. I'm gonna go ahead and call the Black Circle headquarters completed, and yeah, so that should be an adventure. Until then! Hey, you made it to the end. Nice. You had a good time? Check out one of these other series, see if you like them. Drop a like, comment, or subscribe if you'd like to support the channel, via the machine and all that. As always, thanks for watching!